Welcome back, guys. Dave here from SonicOrbStudios, and the aerial video platform version 2 is fully ready to run. In fact, I've done some test runs on it. It's been a while since I've done some uploads on this, and I know I skipped one. So I'm going to go over a lot of things in this one video rather than go back and post another video. But as you can see, it's all wired up. There are plenty of wires around here. I could probably neaten things up, do some custom wiring and such. We do have things set in place, though. So some thoughts to start off with. The wiring harness is in here. It's a little bit sloppy because I had to add to it. So I said there were multiple tiers in this, and I was going to squeeze the wiring harness under there, under the flight controller, because there was a small space. That was a really, really tight fit for any type of wiring. I probably could have made the wiring harness a little bit flatter, but in general, I would like to have seen a little bit more space there. Somebody on Instagram posted saying that the pivot joints for these boom arms, the screws, like to loosen up. So as part of your pre-flight check, make sure you go through and make sure that all of those are tight. There should be four pivots on this particular frame, and the other two arms are fixed in place with multiple screws. But always a nice thing to do is to check, make sure things are nice and tight. Motors, I put some Loctite in the hubs here because the heads on here, they are not left and right hand cross threads, so they will loosen up over time. So I figured, hey, I might as well put some Loctite on there, blue, and they seem to be sticking really well, and Loctite and everything screw-wise in general. We are running two receivers, because there's the gimbal underneath here. The gimbal is the Zenmoose AG4. It is the three-axis gimbal, so you guys can see it'll spin around in place. You can do a pivot, and of course, the roll. So it does work really nicely. I will probably put some media on here that I did some quick test flying around. I just got to put Windows 7 back on one of my laptops so that I can get to the configuration and set this thing up so that it works a little bit better, because right now it's not set up all that well for what I need to do. It's limited to like 90 degrees. It won't spin all around. Anyway, it is pretty heavy. I've got a lot of fly time out of it. I did two packs, and it seems to be flying about 6 minutes. Now, I kept saying I wanted to go for 10 minutes, but 6 minutes seems to be where it's at, running a 5K 4-cell pack, the Turnji Nanotech, and this is, of course, the 35-70C, and it seems to be doing okay. I might try some lighter weight batteries. I'm not going to be able to fit a second battery pack on here because the video transmitter and such is in the way back over on this side, as well as the GPS for the flight controller. GPS for on-screen display, we're using the Hobby King Tiny OSD, I think it is, or something like that. But it's, I believe, under $100 for this thing. Pretty darn good. You just got to wire it in. There's a module here, there's a module here, and of course a module in the power train of it, so you can see the milliamp hours and or the kilowatt hours, whatever that you pulled, whatever it is. Anyway, gimbal we're running, since everything is on a 4-cell, we got this ready-made RC 6 input max voltage regulator. Puts out 5 and 12 volts. The 5 volts is going to the receivers, and the 12 volt is going down to the gimbal there, so it gets nice filtered power on it. Other than that, I think it's pretty darn good. It's a little heavy. In fact, I got the scale out here, so I figured I'd tilt this off to the side carefully and sort of rest it on the scale. And you guys can see, hopefully, get that on there. We're reading about 3.14, 3.15 kilograms. So about 3,000 kilograms, or 3,000 grams, I should say. Let's see if we can't go. So that's about 6 pounds, 14 ounces, or 6.9 pounds. So 7 pounds. It's heavy. It really is, with the battery on there and the retracts and everything. I still have not done the carbon fiber on the retracts, so they're still aluminum, a little bit heavy, but honestly, I think it's just everything on here, the battery in general. It's probably not going to get any more flight time out of it than I already have. Who knows, though? I may run some more calculations with eCalc and see if I can optimize the type of battery that I've got on here, the capacity. Maybe I can run a larger one without weighing it down too much. The motors were a little bit warm after a 6 minute fly time, but nothing unreasonable. The retracts are holding up well and they're quite fast. I'm very happy with that. Zenmoose gimbal has the internal video that seems to patch through very nicely. I just gotta run it with Windows 7 to fix it up. But other than that, guys, it's really, really well done. I like the P2 flight controller on here by JIYI. The only gripe there is that micro USB connection that I really can't get to easily at all. It's somewhere buried in there. But anyway, guys, yeah, that's gonna wrap up a quick video. Sorry if the framing wasn't all that great. I'm sort of not paying too much attention to it, but sort of just a short little vlog showing that it is done. You will see some test flight video right now, and then of course in the future I will be posting more test flight stuff. But if you guys have any thoughts, inputs on maybe getting a better flight time out of this, let me know. And of course go back to the previous uploads where I go over all the details and such, including motors, props, and all that jazz that I've used for this particular hexacopter. Thank you for watching, guys. Comments below, give me a like on the video, and if you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe button. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.